Hi, Epifire. Right, following on from our conversation from a couple of days ago, or longer, there's only two small issues with this model that I don't know if you're going to be able to fix easily or not. Basically, it's just the position of the chrome shafts that I've renamed piston shafts. So that one and that one. That one's not so bad, but it's canted off to the right. But that one, let's just have a look. Hang on. Yeah, it's off by, what's that, 8 units? It's towed down. So that way. That one is towed that way also. What basically the issue is, these cylinders, the large one and the small one, don't line up too well with the crankshaft. Now, I can straighten the piston shaft here up so that that is perpendicular, but what would happen is it's already really, really close to the chassis of the, or stroke body of the engine. And you see there's literally no space there. So basically, if I move it across any further, it would be essentially rubbing on the side of the chassis. In fact, it's probably too close as it is. So what would help would be that cylinder there, if it could be moved that way. But now, obviously, then if you move that one that way, then this one, it'll start hitting the side of that. If you have the master of this model, making that cylinder smaller so that it can move inwards a bit as well, and that one over so that can, and so there's a bit more clearance between the edge of this shaft and the edge of that the body stroke chassis, the engine, and then obviously have the cam lobes on the crankshaft there and there, or big end lobes I should say, perpendicular, line up exactly with the holes there. Basically, the reason I'm asking for this is that obviously it took me flipping ages with the speed. The frequency was fairly obvious straight away. I got that within the first 5 minutes. I set that to spin at 360, and then everything else around it, wait, including the com rod pins, they are also 360 as well. But the con rod and the piston shaft, their frequency is always two. But basically, what's happening is I get wobbled up and down on the end of that shaft, so it basically wobbles up and down in that motion. Now, I've managed to reduce that to the point where you don't really see it almost. But what I'm getting is I'm getting motion from left to right, and the reason I'm getting that is, as you can see, the shaft is tilted to the left there because I can't have it to get it to line up with that hole there, and for the crank not to rub on. I mean, it's already too far over as it is. You can see it's, that'll clip into the edge of the bodywork of the chassis. So this is me playing around with it. If I put that back where it was, let's move this across so that nothing clips. As you can see now, I'm gonna have to twist that shaft even more. So just bear with me a sec. I've been playing around testing different versions of Dark Radiant, and it screwed up my preferences. Right, so where were we? So if I rotate that a little bit, wrong way. Why isn't it rotating? Ah, there we go. See, now it's really on the piss, as it were. So now what you'll see, that'll make this movement where it moves from left to right even more so. So basically, in a nutshell, what I'm asking for, if it's possible, is to move that piston that way, move that piston that way. So obviously that one will have to be made smaller to allow the two to be moved in, and have the crank shaft align perfectly perpendicular to the holes inside that the piston shafts go into. Hope that was clear or made sense, mate.